With the conclusion of the second set between Karasuno vs. Kamomedai, we're about to enter uncharted waters. From here on out, we have no clear idea of who will come out as the victor in this match. Based on what's been shown throughout this quarterfinal bout, sides have definitely been taken within the Haikyu fanbase. Many have chosen our Crows of Karasuno to prevail, while others see Kamomedai claiming victory in this match. But you're probably asking yourself, why choose the opposition? Why support the team that is going against the main cast at the biggest volleyball tournament in the country? Well, what if I told you that if Karasuno were to win this game, we could be staring at the conclusion of the series a lot sooner than we think? And if I told you that should Karasuno lose, we could see the story continue for years to come. The importance of this match could very well set in stone what might be left or what remains of the Haikyu series. So let's get right into it. Why Kamomedai must defeat Karasuno. As of right now, the assumption is that after Kamomedai, the next opponent to tackle will be Fukuradani. Bokuto and his group have been viewed as one of the teams to look out for throughout this tournament, and with Inarizaki and Munjin Izaka both being out, the odds of them making the finals are a lot higher than what they were at the start. We know that Itachiyama, led by one of the three aces of Japan, Kiyomi Sakaza, is looking to be one of the teams to make the finals, since they are the reigning and defending champions of the competition, and the odds-on favorites to win it all again. And as of right now, there is no team that I can see that would be able to match up with them outside Fukuradani, who were able to win a set against them in the Tokyo qualifiers, and potentially one of the other two teams in the current matchup, but lean towards more Kamomedai, considering how I view Hoshiyumi to be one of the top players moving forward if we were to get a year two. But this is where things become a little unclear. We assume it's Fukuradani that Karasuno will face in the next round should they win this match against Kamomedai. However, like we've seen throughout the competition, the brackets for who is facing who have always been concealed, and we never had a clear direction of who is taking on who until after the matches have been played. In fact, it's almost a guarantee that should Karasuno prevail against Kamomedai, they wouldn't be facing Fukuradani until potentially the finals. The brackets were shown once again after Karasuno vs. Nekama, which showed Fukuradani on the opposite side in their matchup against Munjin Izaka. And seeing as Fukuradani are on the left hand side while Karasuno were on the right, they will not be able to compete against one another unless both teams make the finals. Furudate Sensei has done a great job building up the opponents that have come across Karasuno's way during Inter High. We had, in my opinion, the best match in the series against Inarizaki, an emotional thriller against Nekama that saw our Crows finally defeat their rivals in an official match, and now we are witnessing another classic go down against Kamomedai. Hinata vs. Hoshiyumi. The battle to determine who is the new little giant, or in this case, the birth of the greatest decoy. It has all the makings of being the best match in the series to date when all is said and done. But after that match, what's next? I have a hard time believing that Furudate Sensei would have Karasuno go up against a random opponent in the semifinals with little to no build-up before the match starts. Each match that Karasuno has had up to this point carried a meaning of importance. With little to no build-up going into the semifinals from the other opposing sides, it wouldn't feel as special as it should be. That could change, however, should Itachiyama actually be the team that Karasuno faces depending on where exactly the reigning champions were seated in the brackets. Considering that Itachiyama were the first seed for winning the Tokyo qualifiers, being Fukuradani who finished as the second seed, and Nekama placing third after defeating Nohibe, it would make a lot more sense to have the first and third seed on one side of the bracket and the second seed being on the other. Another reason for why Karasuno needs to lose pertains to Furudate planting the seeds for future events later on in the series, those that involve the teams that Karasuno has faced off against that seek revenge games, bragging rights, and tiebreakers. Not to mention the possibility of seeing new recruits coming out of middle school to enter high school, seeing as they will help bolster some of the rosters that they will be missing players upon graduation for a lot of the third years. A series you may have heard of called Diamond OAs has done a fantastic job adapting its story from year 1 to year 2, showing you how they are trying to become even better given the things that didn't pan out for them in the previous year. Along with the hazy brackets and future events, we have to be honest with ourselves. This Karasuno team, while they have improved immensely, aren't ready to win a championship just yet. Itachiyama are the team I feel are the undeniable favorites to win it all again. Fukuradani are the potential kryptonite, and from what we have seen so far from Kamomedai, being a max-style Date Tech level team, they even have a shot at going to the finals. We have to give credit where it's due for how Coach Yukai has assembled the squad, but surely enough they will run into a wall they cannot break down, that wall being possibly Kamomedai, or in actuality being Itachiyama. While this next reason is more of how I view the importance of the Three Aces title that Sakaza, Kiryu, and Ushijima hold, it would be in my eyes a disappointment for Sakaza to lose at any point in time to Karasuno during Inter High. Ushijima and Kiryu are done high school after this year, so their paths have already been set. Sakusa is only in his second year. He, in my opinion, might be the best player in the country based on the reputation of his title, the team that he plays for, and his role in Japan's future with the national youth team. And though we've only scratched the surface of his character, he has the makings of being a long-term rival for Hinata and Kageyama to try and overcome before Itachiyama's ace moves on to bigger and better things. And speaking of the national youth team, don't forget that right after Shiratorizawa's matchup, we saw Kageyama train with the All-Japan youth team, which could set up a potential match for Japan's under-18s against the United States or a team hailing from Europe or Asia. This could even help with Hinata deciding if he's going to create his own path and continue to strive to be one of the best in the game, or follow the same path that Tenma Yudai did after completing high school. And given the fact that in the manga recently we had learned that Hinata wants to be called the greatest decoy if he is given a nickname, that kind of gives you the idea that is he looking for something long term to be remembered as, or after this year? And I think seeing a matchup of that caliber for the first time would give him the idea that he would want to keep doing this for a long time for people to truly remember him as the greatest decoy. With the many routes after nationals that open up the story both from a narrative and longevity standpoint, it would be too early to end a story such as this with how much is still yet to be explored or even developed that the readers would be satisfied with such an ending, knowing that there is still more out there to explore. And seeing how Karasuno are coming off their victory over Nekoma, which is already tough for them both physically and emotionally, there is a chance it'll come back to haunt them against Kamomedai, and I'm still holding on to the idea that Kamomedai will come out of this match as the victor, leading to Karasuno bowing out of nationals and preparing for themselves to go on to their second year and try to do it all again. It all comes down to this match that will either make or break the chances of this manga continuing for many years to come, or the beginning of the end of one of the best sports series to grace the covers of Weekly Shonen Jump. But let me know down in the comment section below, how do you see all this panning out? Who do you have as the victor of this match in your head? Do you see Karasuno coming out as the winner, or do you see Kamomedai coming out as the winner? Let me know what kind of scenario you can see playing out from all of this down in the comments below. Like the video if you enjoyed, subscribe to the channel if you guys are new here. If you want to be part of the weekly experience when it comes to my coverage of the Haikyu manga every single week, I do cover the manga and I will be covering the anime when it does come out in January of 2020. And with that being said, I will catch you guys in the next Haikyu video. So, Commodore Lad signing off. Thank you so much for watching, and as always, take care. Going crazy.